शिष्यानंदमयी मात की जय। क्वेश्चन, माँ, इट इज बिलीव दैट इन ऑर्डर टू एग्जॉस्ट वंस कर्मा रिजल्ट्स ऑफ फॉर्मर एक्शंस वन हैज टू टेक ऑन अ बॉडी, कैन कर्मा नॉट बी एग्जॉस्टेड विदाउट एज्यूमिंग अनदर बॉडी? माँ, इवन वेन द फिजिकल बॉडी डाइज देर आर अदर सटल बॉडीज। Question, then is it possible to work out one's karma in an ethereal body? Ma, there are quite a lot of karmas for which a physical body is needed. So one has to be reborn in a new body. But there are other karmas that can be worked out in a subtle body. The one is constantly leading human beings towards himself. Everyone will at some time or other reach the supreme goal because this is the man's destiny. To become established in his own true being is man's inherent tendency. Question. Ma, by samskar, we usually understand the results that will ensue due to one's previous actions. Has a human being the capacity to perform actions that will enable him to attain to the Supreme Brahman or the Supreme Goal? Ma, this is why it is said that it is the Guru who out of his grace leads to that goal. It is impossible to achieve merely by performing action. Question. When you speak of becoming established in one's true being, this seems to be the ultimate state reached by sadhana. But one also hears of states of existence such as Shivlok or Vishnu Lok, etc., which the power instilled by the Guru into the disciple may subsequently enable him to attain, but beyond which the disciple cannot proceed. So how can it be that everybody is able to reach the supreme goal, which is to be established in one's own self? Ma, what you say is also true. Frequently, it is seen that human beings become arrested on particular levels. But if a person has the inborn tendency, he may, after temporary confinement, at one level proceed higher up. Others may spend age after age in the same state. There are so many possibilities. Is there an end to this subject? Pramath, I don't understand all these bickerings over knowledge and worlds after death. I just want to make sure that since you are here as our mother, do we have to acquire all this knowledge to know you? Ma, you are a practicing lawyer. Do you do your work without having studied law? Pramath, by what kind of studies have you yourself acquired all this wisdom? Ma, leave aside the question of this body. Abhay, you are so great that one cannot compare anyone with you. Ma, I do not ask you to leave aside the question of this body because it is so great. You can ask this body to go to hell. Everybody burst into loud laughter. Do you not frequently call someone an idiot? You can ignore this body as an idiot. Again, loud laughter. Pramath, this is not what I mean. I must repeat that I want to realize Ma. Now, do I have to acquire all this knowledge in order to realize Ma? Or will I automatically obtain all this knowledge by realizing who Ma is? Ma. By realizing Ma, you will have gained everything. Did I not say only the other day that the mother wishes to give everything to her children? It is the mother's sole desire that whatever she possesses should belong to her children. Pramath, indeed, this is very heartening news. I understand this quite well. But Ma, do you know what happens to me when I listen to all this people discussing abstruse knowledge. I start suspecting my own feelings. I imagine these people have stolen away everything and I have been cheated. Laughter. Ma, listen. Even though the goal is the same, the paths taken by different people are of great variety. Some choose the path of knowledge, discriminating, not this. Niti. Others tread the path of devotion and yet others of dedicated action. But the objective is the same. Pramath, I do not relish all these questions. Ma, when one starts studying and gains a little knowledge, questions are bound to arise. Questions multiply in proportion to the increase of one's knowledge. On the other hand, he who has never touched a book does not gain any knowledge, nor do any questions occur to him. There is yet another category of individuals who have no problems and therefore no questions. Pramath, so it seems that I belong to this category. Everybody laughs. Ma, this is quite obvious. But they do not harbor any suspicion that they have been cheated. Pramath, so in order to realize Ma, we cannot evade all this knowledge. Ma, see here, have I not pointed out a moment ago that it is the natural disposition of the human being to become aware of the treasure hidden within himself? The true nature of man is to move in this direction. In this natural process, he cannot avoid anything. You may have observed the natural flow of water. If water is poured out, it starts flowing. Should there be a hole on the way, so long as the hole is not filled entirely, the water cannot flow any further. But as soon as the hole is full, the water resumes its course. Similarly, the individual quite naturally moves towards peace and tranquility. Along the way, he cannot avoid anything that happens to be there. So nothing remains unknown to him. That is why I repeat, set to work. Effort is a necessity. Nevertheless, attainment does not ensue due to one's own exertion. By His mercy alone, everything becomes possible. Shri Shri Anandamayi Mat Ki Jai.